Sisters and brothers of America, it fills my heart with joy unspeakable to rise in response to the warm and cordial welcome that you have given us. I thank you in the name of the ancient monks. I thank you in the name of the mother of religions, and I thank you in the name of the millions and millions of Hindu people of all classes and sects. My thanks also to some of the speakers on this platform who, while referring to the delegates from the Orient, have told you that these men from far off nations may well claim the honor of bearing to different lands the idea of toleration. I'm proud to belong to a religion which has taught the world both tolerance and universal acceptance. We believe not only in universal toleration, but we accept all religions as true. I'm proud to belong to a nation which has sheltered the persecuted and the refugees of all nations, of all religions of the earth. I'm proud to tell you that we have gathered in our bosom the purest remnants of Israelites who came to southern India and took refuge with us in the very year in which the holy temple was shattered to pieces by Roman tyranny. I'm proud. I'll quote to you, brethren, a few lines from a hymn which I remember to have repeated from my earliest boyhood and which is repeated by millions of human beings every day. As the different streams, having their sources in different places, all mingle their water in the sea, so, O Lord, the different paths which men take through different tendencies, various though they appear, crooked or straight, all lead to Thee. This present convention, which is one of the most august assemblies ever held, is in itself a vindication, a declaration to the world of the wonderful doctrine preached in the Gita. Whosoever comes to me, through whatsoever form I reach him, all men are struggling through paths which in the end leads to me. Sectarianism, bigotry, and its horrible descendant fanaticism have long possessed this beautiful earth. They have filled the earth with violence, drenched it often and often with human blood, destroyed civilizations, and sent whole nations to despair. Had it not been for these horrible demons, human society would be far more advanced than it is now. When their time is come, I fervently hope that the bell that tolled this morning in the honor of this convention may be the death knell of all fanaticism, of all persecution, with the sword or with the pen, and of all uncharitable feelings between persons wending their way towards the same